Welcome to the last session of Chapter 4, History of Indian Arts. Children, we had learnt about traditions of classical performing arts. We had started learning about this heading, and also we had learnt the 9 modes, that is 9 Nava Rasas. Let's continue with the traditions of classical performing arts only. Indian people came into contact with cultural traditions of other nations, and as a result, many styles of presenting of classical vocal music, instrumental music and dance came into existence. To preserve these styles, many schools were also created. There are actually 2 branches of the Indian classical music. One is Hindustani music and second one is Carnatic music. Same way, even there are 2 forms of it, classical and semi-classical, which includes many styles of folk music. Lavani of Maharashtra, Kathak of North India, Odissi in Odisha, Bharatanatyam of Tamil Nadu, Kathakali and Mohiniyattam of Kerala has a beautiful blend of all 3 forms of music, vocal, instrumental and dance. In India, many festivals of music and dance are organized with a view to make it reach the common people. The Savai Gandharva festival of Pune is a famous one. Pandit Uday Shankar is a prominent artist who created a fusion of Indian classical dance and European opera. He has included various forms of folk dance in his style, which has a big scope for expansion. The same phenomena is applicable in the field of Indian visual arts. Children, you can see on the screen. It's about 2 dances. Lavani dance, which belongs to Maharashtra, and at the right hand side, it's Kathakali dance, which belongs to Kerala. Do you know, children, about Ibrahim Adil Shah II? The ruler of Bijapur, Ibrahim Adil Shah II, wrote a text in Persian language and it was named as Kitab-e-Navaras, about Indian classical music. It has verses sung in the Dhrupad style and makes the audience to experience the joy of excellent poetry. This text has been edited in Marathi by Dr. Arun Prabhune. Translation in English is given and it is as follows. O Mother Saraswati, you are the divine light in the world and you are complete with all qualities. If Ibrahim receives your grace, blessings, the poetry of the Navaras will become eternal. The last heading which we are going to learn is art, applied art and professional opportunities. Children, this point is very, very important from your future point of view. Let's learn about arts. Various opportunities of research are available in this field. Can take an example of art historians. Art historians can work in this field of journalism. Art market calls for special expertise to assess the exact value of an art object or to ensure that it is genuine. An expert with deep understanding of art history is always required for this task. Students of art can find many professional opportunities in heritage management and cultural tourism. Museums, archives management, library science and information technology, archaeological research, Indology are some other fields in this regard. Indology is a study of Indian history, literature, philosophy and culture. Let's learn about applied art. At the end of the chapter, we are going to learn about applied art. The basic aim of visual and performing arts is entertainment for people. But still there is a scope to combine an artistic creation with utility value. An artistic creation with the utilitarian purpose is called applied art. The main aim of this visual and performing arts
is to entertain the people, but at the same time, it possesses certain utility value. An artistic creation with this utilitarian purpose is called applied art. It means whatever knowledge an artist has, when the same knowledge is applied into different professional opportunities, it becomes applied art. So let's learn about different opportunities or professional opportunities that are there in this field.
Industrial and advertisement, interior design, production of ornamental object, art design of stage, backdrops, naipatya, which means art direction of films and television, creating layouts of books, greeting cards, customized stationery, gift objects are other fields of applied art. The field of architecture, photography, animated graphics are a part of applied art. Ornaments, artistic creation of metals, earthen pots with colorful designs, cane, bamboo objects, glass objects, attractive textiles, clothing, all can be listed under applied arts. Each of the following work of arts need a systematic planning, meticulous management of every stage of production. The syllabi of training courses of art design include the history of various industrial and cultural traditions. Do you know about NID children? NID is National Institute of Design in Ahmedabad in Gujarat. Is a world-renowned institute which has online courses since 2015.
Children, after studying about applied art, definitely this has been included in your standard 10th syllabus to make you aware about the number of professional opportunities that are there. If you are keenly interested to make your career in the field of art, the above opportunities, professional opportunities, will definitely help you out. Thank you.
We have completed the whole chapter in 3 sessions. After this, you need to read the whole chapter, and there is an exercise that is provided in your standard 10th history course book. Read the chapter, mark down all the answers in the text and learn them, as well as note them down in your classwork. Thank you.